The 50-megawatt thermal plant was developed by Jacobsen Electro in 2006 as part of the initiatives to salvage the energy crisis that had rocked the country. The plant's operation and maintenance has been taken over by the Uganda Electricity Generation Company Limited on behalf of the government.
All I can say is that we are a government agency. We are not profit-driven. These were private investors, so probably they had a high return on their investment. But once we take over as a government agency, our main objective is really service provision.
The takeover is expected to lead to annual savings of up to 7.7 billion shillings for the first 3 years of UEGCL operating and maintaining the plant, and 9 billion shillings thereafter. UEGCL was initially poised to take over the plant upon expiry of Jacobsen Electro's agreement in 2020, but this was delayed.
We realized that we had financial obligations and other obligations to do, and I had to inform the Ministry of Finance to make sure that money is available so that we recognize Jacobsen, who have been doing a very great job.
Key among the contentious issues were the compensation to the Norwegian firm for the unrecovered investment that the company had made.
The way the BOT works is that the investor recovers all his money. After recovering his money, then he transfers the asset back to government at actually no cost. But for this plant, I think the minister has explained, there were some other obligations, like they had fuel in the storage tanks, they had spare parts in the store. So those are some of the costs that the government had to reimburse them.
Uganda has several private generation facilities developed under the Build, Operate and Transfer Agreement that is in line to be taken over by the government. Government has already indicated that it will not renew Eskom's concession at the Kira and Nalubale Power upon expiry next year. UEGCL has already indicated readiness to take over the two plants. Story by Ben Onojambo for the news.